Welcome back to Innovation Oxford. Right now we're going to go inside the CAMI Automotive Assembly Plant here in Ingersoll to discover how they're coping with change. And that change is they've got an immensely successful vehicle, the Equinox. It's going to involve some changes in production processes and, dare I say it, Kaizen, continuous improvement. Let's take a look inside. Angelo, tell us what we're about to see here.
What we're going to show you today is really two pieces of equipment that are somewhat unique to the industry. The first piece of equipment we're going to show you is what we call as our master body gauge. And really what it is, it's something that we've utilized about 10 years ago. And the idea around this master body gauge was really to understand how all of the parts that we assemble in the body shop to fabricate the vehicle, how they all fit together. It's very critical that from a quality perspective, all these parts, you know, have a relationship to each other, and that we understand that relationship, and that relationship needs to transfer into the tool. So what we're seeing here is really a replication of how the tools would put the parts together. So it helps us understand if we have parts issues, if we have tooling issues, those kinds of things. But it's the baseline for us to really establish where our vehicle is dimensionally with the available parts and the quality of the parts that are coming in. And then once we understand the individual quality of the parts, we can go and address issues, quality issues that are related.
It's over here. What is that actually telling you?
For example, this particular part here is the side body, and this is actually the side of the vehicle.
Of an Equinox.
Of an Equinox, yeah. And what you're seeing is this particular side body is actually clamped in location that the body would need to be put together. So this really replicates where this should be from a design perspective.
And so you test these every so often?
Well, what we do is we take this body side, we'll put it into our fixture, and then marry it up to the other components that either go into the body side or marry into an underbody. By doing that, we can see the relationship of each of those parts as we would see the relationship in our assembly fixtures. We'll see discrepancies here that tell us that potentially there's a part that may be going out of spec, or we're starting to wander to a high side of a nominal or a low side of a nominal. So that helps us in understanding, if there's potential dimensional issues, and we can go in and make, you know, small adjustments, but more importantly, we can contact our vendors or whoever's supplying us our parts, because some of these are supplied internally, to go in, understand the problem, and make whatever adjustments are appropriate to get that part back into dimensional. What this piece of equipment does is, after we finish a completed body, as you see here, or we can actually also take sub-assemblies, this is a very, very precise instrument that actually measures certain points on the body or on the part. And what we try to do is understand how we're building the vehicle relative to how it was designed. So if we start to see something get out of tolerance, this will pick it up very, very quickly and it'll flag us.
Is it computerized?
It's computerized. It's fully automated.
Absolutely.
This is the foundation of the vehicle. We absolutely have to have a good foundation, because everything that happens after the vehicle is built in the body shop is really just added to it. So the idea here is really to build a good foundation and understand where your foundation is and check it on a regular basis.
You may have noticed us walking around the CAMI plant that we're wearing, of course, our safety glasses. We're standing on the green line where it's safe for us to walk in this 1.7 million square foot plant. And of course, I'm wearing my Kevlar. This is Kevlar. I can dodge bullets. Not that there are any here, but this is how serious CAMI is about safety in this facility.
What we're looking at is an add-on board, and really it's our communication board for all of the people that are building the vehicle on the line. There's a fair amount of information that's displayed on that. For instance, we have two types of vehicles that we build in here, both the Equinox and the Terrain. Each of those may take some unique parts, so it would tell you that vehicle that's coming down the line would take a unique part. That's some of the information it tells you.
So on this board, we know it's time. It's lunch hour here, 20-minute lunch.
Correct.
So things have slowed down a little bit. Tell us about the bottom numbers.
Bottom numbers are where we are in production. For instance, the 98 represents how many vehicles we built. We should have built 99, but we're
down one, minus one.
Minus one, correct.
The percentage, the 99 represents the efficiency of the department. Like we're at that, because we would be 100% if we were building 99
right.
vehicles.
Right.
And then the 98 represent the utilization. So it's a different measure, but we're looking at both of those as different measures.
So Angelo, is this good news?
Actually, you don't want to see the negative one. You'd always want to see a positive. But again, that's real life. And again, at the end of the shift, we'll make it up.
Yeah, you'll make it up by the end of the shift.
Right.
So it'll be at 100%.
Absolutely.
We'll be right back with more innovation here at the CAMI Automotive Assembly Plant. Stay tuned. It's a problem, but it's a great problem to have. To be building 1,100 Equinox vehicles here at the CAMI plant in Ingersoll, and then to build an additional 250 and ship them to Oshawa simply to meet the North American demand.
We ship the finished body to Oshawa, and Oshawa, what they will do is they'll paint it, and then they'll put on all the assembly parts, the engine, the transmission, seats, all of the interior components, the wheels, and then that's a finished product.
Well, on average, we could probably, we get about 10 years life out of a robot, and past that, then the technology takes over, and the robots really become out of date, and it's mostly because of technology.
Angelo, I thought a robot lasted forever. You're telling me that they don't.
We have some robots that have lasted forever. Back when the robots were first introduced back in the 80s, we still have robots that are still working, but again, in our business where every 6 or 7 years, you're retooling a shop, and you're really looking for the optimum and the most efficient way of retooling that. So really, technology has a lot to play with.
And hit the top thing. No, hit your finger.
That's all?
Well, you want it a little deeper than that.
You better bang. I don't want to hurt the car.
You won't hurt the car.
So.
You want to try to hurt the car.
Really?
In that
you
aspect,
must love your job.
I do.
And so if that doesn't burn, it's a good one.
From the time we began till now, 3 hours have elapsed to get this car body to this point in the manufacturing process. Tell us a little bit about what appears to be something insignificant, but from your perspective, it's pretty significant.
Well, absolutely. What you see here in this station is a in-house built synchro cart. This cart allows our PA in station to maintain their tooling, their fasteners. If you notice here on this particular station, we have an electric pokey yoke tool, which is a line stop tool that ensures proper torque on a fastener. All of the things the PA needs to complete their various processes stay on this cart, which travels along with the vehicle, as you can see overhead, and reduces the waste required for this individual to walk typically to the line side, to a bench to collect their fasteners. They're not required to carry the fasteners in their hand. They're not required to wear a pouch for the tools. They have everything they need to do the job efficiently in a very small footprint line side. The tools are never out of their reach.
And did you develop this in-house?
Yeah, this is an example. Synchro carts are built in-house. We have an in-house Kaizen shop. Our team leaders can build these. They are all made Allen key fasteners, wrenches, in-house, cut. They can be disassembled, modified to meet our requirements. And again, very simple, doesn't require a large degree of complex engineering, doesn't require any outside vendor. Obviously, we have an in-house safety buy-offs from our safety committees. We want to make sure that they're built properly, safely, and that they're ergonomically sound for the operator.
And so this has saved a small bit of production time, multiplied many times over.
Absolutely.
how do you move production when you can't change the real estate or cut the concrete? Move it from 700 vehicles a day to 1,100 vehicles a day, because that's the new target. And I'm here with Andrew, who's going to explain some of the modifications that they've done to assembly.
Well, one example is installing multiple nut runners. For example, on this unit right here. We use these four fasteners with one tool, so the operator would load a fastener and then fasten each one individually. So we installed this, and it was an idea from the pilot team and from the people on the floor to make it a multiple nut runner. So we can do all those four fasteners simultaneously, which we're doing right now.
And that was designed in-house here?
Yes, it was. Yes, it was.
Do I use the term Kaizen, continuous improvement?
Absolutely. Yeah. Correct. And at the same time, this process allowed the same operator to do another process. In this case, he's tensioning the parking brake system. So while that is going through its cycle, he's able to finish those four fasteners in the same pitch, in the same workspace.
And so that's just one example of the hundreds of small changes
that's
that you've
correct.
Made that gets you to increase your productivity.
That's correct. Every second counts. So we look at every second, and we try to eke out everything we can out of each process to eliminate the waste.
It looks like you have, Andrew.
I think so in this case.
It's been an amazing visit here at the CAMI assembly plant in Ingersoll. They've had to meet extraordinary challenges. They couldn't change the real estate. They had to use their existing setup to meet the ever-increasing demand for the Equinox vehicle. You've seen some of the small ways they've done that, and there's more to come here at this incredible plant. I'm Mike Harding for Innovation Oxford. See you next time.